Hello, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to give you 4 steps to determine if your WordPress site is slow. Running tests on your website is a great way to determine what's slowing down your site, whether it's your web hosting provider, the website itself, or both. In this video, we'll walk through some website tests that you can run. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's determine if your site is slow. How fast does your site load? Any website that takes more than 2 seconds to load isn't good for the user experience. Ideally, you should aim for load times below 1 second. Anything in between is fine, but you should always look into optimizing it further. There are different website speed test tools you can use for this purpose, but I will use the GT Metrics and Pingdom tools to demonstrate this step. First, let's fire up GT Metrics and test the website. Choose a server location closest to you or your site's visitors for better results. Go ahead and sign up for a free GT Metrics account for more server location options. Here, we're testing the WordPress site's homepage, as that's what most users will visit. Also, the homepage houses a lot of content, so it's ideal for testing. Once the test completes, you'll see a GT Metrics performance report as seen here. GT Metrics grades a web page based on many metrics. It also provides a visual timeline of how the page loaded during the test. To understand it in detail, you'll have to scroll down. The summary tab highlights all the major issues impacting your site's performance. In this case, the topmost problem is the server's response time. It almost always implies looking into upgrading your hosting plan or migrating to a better host. However, before you jump to that conclusion, it's better to fix all the other issues and revisit this. The next major issue is avoid an excessive DOM size, a common issue when using page builders. The other issue, avoid large layout shifts, can also be related to page builders or themes. Avoid enormous network payloads refers to heavy loading assets such as images, scripts, and CSS files. The page details section gives a quick rundown of that. Here, you can see that the total page size and the number of page requests are pretty high. Not using a CDN plays another critical role in slowing down your WordPress site. Clicking the Performance tab will present you with more metrics reported by the browser and Lighthouse Performance. As you can see, this test webpage has nothing well going for it. Going to the Report Structure and Waterfall tabs will give you even more insights. Next up is Pingdom Tools, another popular speed testing tool. We'll test the same site's homepage again here. Pingdom Tools uses its own algorithm to test the webpage. The results don't look great for this site here either. Scrolling down further will show you how to improve your site's performance. Expanding each recommendation will give you more details about where and how you can improve. As each speed testing tool has its own performance metrics, you can't directly compare one speed test results with another. So no matter what you choose, it's best to stick with one. Finally, you should also consider the difference between a site's perceived performance and actual performance. Putting your website under a load test will reveal new information about how fast it is in the real world. We'll use K6 for this, a free and open source load testing tool that can run locally on your system. These results are for the same site being put under load test for 10 minutes with a maximum of 50 virtual users. The dashboard also includes other helpful stats. Notice that most of the requests failed, probably indicating that the server cannot handle them. You can also set up thresholds and checks in K6 scripts. These metrics will also show up neatly in the dashboard. This image shows another site's load testing results using the exact conditions to give you a clearer picture. Having 28 failed requests may seem bad, but it isn't when considering the total number of requests. That's just 0.25% of all the requests made by my local machine. The results here indicate that this site's web hosting provider can serve quite a decent amount of concurrent users. Testing your WordPress site theme and plugins should be the next major step in discovering any major performance issues. There's a lot of variety here. You'll often find that some themes and plugins are better optimized than others. Earlier, we discussed spotting problematic themes or plugins in the reports, but there's another direct way to go about it. Disable one of the themes or plugins at a time and see how the site performs in a speed test, load test, or both. If the performance issue persists, disable one more theme or plugin and rerun the test. Continue doing this until you found the culprits. However, that approach is a no-go for production sites. Having a staging site really helps here. You can use it to test various iterations of your production site by adding, changing, or removing specific features. Most web hosting providers, especially cheap shared hosting plans, don't provide this feature by default. So you'll have to manually set the staging site up or use a WordPress staging plugin. If your site is hosted at Kinsta, you're lucky, as every WordPress install at Kinsta comes with its staging environment. All you need to do is head over to your My Kinsta dashboard, choose your site, and change its environment from live to staging. This staging site is virtually an exact copy of your production site, right down to its server and server-side configurations. You can use it to tinker and test your website without affecting its live version. An APM tool combined with speed and load testing tools can supercharge your website diagnostic capabilities. Instead of setting up a staging site and guessing which plugin or theme to disable one by one, a competent APM tool can help you identify the source of slow performance without changing anything on your site. It tracks and analyzes slow transactions, database queries, external requests, WordPress hooks, plugins, and more. Typically, using an APM tool isn't beginner friendly. Even expert developers need some training on how to use it efficiently. Plus, there's always the added cost factor, as most of them require a license to run. If your site is hosted at Kinsta, you can use our free Kinsta APM tool to diagnose its performance issues. It's our custom designed performance monitoring tool for WordPress sites, helping you identify WordPress performance issues. I went out of my way to create an unoptimized site to demonstrate this feature. Next, I turned on Kinsta APM for this site through my Kinsta dashboard. I then put it through a couple of load tests so that Kinsta APM picks up some data, and here are the results. The transactions tab lists the requests that took the most time during the monitoring period. Starting here is an excellent way to optimize your site. In this case, wp-cron.php is the slowest. It can be triggered by WordPress itself, the theme, or any plugin. You can disable wp-cron and replace it with a system cron to improve your site's performance. Next up is Kinsta's APM's WordPress tab. Here you'll find the slowest WordPress plugins and hooks. If you find any unnecessary plugins here or plugins with duplicate functionality, you can remove them from your WordPress site. For instance, I can see two contact form plugins here and a portfolio plugin, which this website can do without. Scrolling further down this tab will show you the slowest WordPress hooks. Tracking the slowest WordPress hooks is one of Kinsta APM's most helpful features. You can click on the hook item to view its transaction samples. By knowing exactly which plugin, theme, or hook is the performance bottleneck, you can boost site performance and reduce page load times. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching, and if you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.